Welcome, parents, family members, community members, and graduates of the class of 2021 from Antioch Community High School. My name is Eric Hamilton, and I am the principal here at Antioch. I want to welcome you to this virtual graduation. Last year, we had to do this out of necessity. This year, we're doing it out of desire, as an additional way to celebrate a class of students that has gone above and beyond, has shown resilience, and has persisted through a pandemic. You truly have shown us what it is to be a Sequoite, and once you're a Sequoite, you're always a Sequoite. I hope you enjoy this video representation of our graduation, and I look forward to seeing you in person at the football stadium. Thank you.
Thank you, Principal Hamilton. Good afternoon, and welcome to the commencement ceremony for the class of 2021 of Antioch Community High School. I am Kylie Craig.
And I am Katie Amadeo. We are selected by our classmates and ACHS faculty as this year's outstanding senior Sequoites, and be proudly serving as your MCs for this evening's ceremony. It's hard to believe that we arrived at ACHS as freshmen just 4 short years ago. Everything was new. It took some of us weeks, and for others years, to figure out where all the stairways and hallways led. We met new people, rose to new expectations, and discovered who we were as young adults. Our experiences were shaped by both students and staff members alike. One of those highly impactful staff members will be speaking today. Please join me in welcoming our faculty speaker, Mr. Michael Riggs.
The faculty speech at graduation during a pandemic. What do you say at a time like this? There are so many things I could say to you on this momentous occasion. I could talk about that old saying and exhort you to go out and be great, but more importantly, be good. I could talk about how we of the older generation are counting on you to go out and do great things in the world, that it's your turn to make a difference. I know that I personally am counting on you and hoping that you'll find a way to do that. I could tell you to follow your dreams, but let's be honest, that doesn't really sound like me now, does it? I could riff on the message that Mr. Murray gave a few years ago when he said not to let this day be the best day of your life. That was one of my favorites that I've heard here, actually. I could spend some time talking about all the lessons that we've learned from the pandemic. And we've learned so many things. I could talk about the importance of perseverance, grit, and adaptability, which have all been driven home by the events of the last year. I could talk about the importance of connection, something that we've all learned during this time, that despite all the technology and all of our possessions, it's the human connection that we miss the most during this lockdown. I could talk about all the lessons we've learned from the pandemic and how we need to apply them going forward so that we don't lose the opportunity that's presented to us through this trial to be better. About how we need not return to normal, but move on to something better. About how we don't need to bounce back from this, but bounce forward. And any of those would be a perfectly cromulent message for a faculty address, but instead, I'd like to wax poetic for a moment. I'll try to watch the time here because I know that some of you have reservations to the Red Lobster and I don't want to make you late. Around this time of year, every year, I'm reminded of a song. Now, it won't be a surprise to anybody that I'm about to talk about music. This one is an old Irish folk song called The Parting Glass. Like its more famous cousin, Auld Lang Syne, this is a going away song. The concept of a parting glass is like a toast, one final hospitality offered to a departing guest. In the text of this song, each stanza offers a view of a different set of scenarios where one person parts from another, one of them leaving, the other left behind. At the end of the chorus each time is a line that forms a sort of toast. Good night and joy be to you all, it says. When I listen to the song, I often wonder what character I am in the story. The fact that I sort of crazily insert myself into the song won't surprise you, nor the fact that I'm sort of crazily shoving myself into this speech. But this time of year, I'm reminded that I and all of the staffalty here are the ones staying behind, saying goodbye. Another line from the song says, of all the comrades that e'er I had, they're sorry for my going away. Well, that's us. We're the ones, we're the comrades who are sorry for your going away. Well, most of you, you know who you are. And it is sad every year, but that's what it is to be a teacher. We stay behind while you all leave, going out into the big wide world to live your lives. And if I may be so presumptuous to speak for my esteemed colleagues, we stand here wishing you, in the words of the song, joy. Now, there's been precious little joy to go around lately, it seems, but let's just take a moment for joy. We're told that while weeping may last for the night, joy comes with the morning. Joy is different from happiness, different from pleasure. The Dalai Lama wrote that at its deepest levels, joy is long-lasting and is characterized by a sense of fulfillment. C.S. Lewis wrote at length on joy, and for him, joy was so high up and so intense that it couldn't be described in words. He wrote of experiencing stabs of joy at various times in his life. Joy, he wrote, is distinct not only from pleasure in general, but even from aesthetic pleasure. It must have the stab, the pang, the inconsolable longing, he said. Psychologist Mihai Csikszentmihalyi has studied the phenomenon of joy and connects it to another phenomenon that he calls flow. Now, anyone who's an athlete or an artist is already familiar with the concept of flow. You know it as being in the zone. He describes it as the mental state in which a person performing some activity is fully immersed in a feeling of energized focus, full involvement, and enjoyment in the process of the activity. Flow is characterized by a complete absorption in what one does, and it results in a profound sense of enjoyment. You experience this sense of flow, and therefore joy, when your skills and interests exactly match the task at hand. And so, in a shock to no one, I'm not going to stand up here and tell you to chase your dreams. At least, not necessarily. Your dream may not pan out, at least not in the way you have in mind right now. But I do hope that each of you can find a scenario, if you haven't already, where your skills and interests exactly match the task at hand. I hope that you experience fulfillment and a sense of joy that is long-lasting. And if I may add my own opinions to the Dalai Lama and C.S. Lewis and so many others, if you sit around waiting for it to come, it may never come to you. You have to do it. And so, class of 2021, I stand here as a small representative of all those who have cared about you these past 4 years at least, and I speak for us all. In fact, we do want you to be great, but more importantly, good. In fact, we do want you to go out into the big wide world and do great things, world-changing, heretofore unimagined things, and you can. In fact, we do hope that today is not the best day of your life, but that many more joyful days are ahead of you. The pandemic has many lessons to teach us, as does life in general, and we hope that you have learned and will continue to learn from what has come to pass and what is yet to come. And we have one other wish for you. Joy be to you all. Congratulations, Clark grads. I can't wait to see what you do next.
Thank you, Mr. Riggs. At this time, some of our ACHS choir seniors will perform a piece entitled High School Musical, arranged by Roger Emerson.
Started, but we leave when we take with us. No matter what, it's time that we're a part of. We learn to. we've ever known. Step into the future and hold on to High School Musical and celebrate where we come from, the friends who've been there all along. Oh yeah, High School Musical. It says we have to let it go. It's the best part we've ever known. Step into the future and hold on to High School Musical.
Thank you, choir. This year, the senior class address will be given by Eli Ruano.
Good evening. I'd like to start with an apology. I had originally planned to be giving this speech from the comfort of my bed, so if I'm a little off, now you know why. I'd also like to start with a thank you. Thank you for allowing me the honor of speaking before Antioch Community High School's graduating class of 2021. Today marks history for Antioch Community High School, because today we are celebrating the strongest class that this school has ever seen. And no, I don't mean physical strength. All of you athletes can save that for the weight deck. In my eyes, our strength has been defined by our ability to prevail through one of the most difficult hardships life can throw at us, a global pandemic. In March of 2020, we were introduced to the coronavirus. School was shut down, activities were canceled, and we were getting what seemed like a free 2-week vacation. I can't speak for everyone, but I was somebody who definitely needed it at the time. Unfortunately, that vacation grew to become something none of us needed or wanted. It became a time of confusion. E-learning was new to all of us, and technology suddenly became something we had to master. For someone who could barely work their way around Google Drive as it is, this was especially hard for me. It became a time of frustration. Junior and senior year are said to be the hardest years of high school. Difficult classes, mandatory testing, and just trying to figure out what life is going to look like after high school is hard enough as it is. I guess the universe didn't agree, though, as they threw in COVID-19 to spice things up. Now, it also became a time of loneliness. We had to distance ourselves from friends, quarantine in our homes, and miss out on the everyday joys of life. COVID-19 clearly surrounded us with negativity. However, I'm truly grateful to have witnessed all of the positive things that grew from it. Community. We found new ways to interact with each other and stay involved through online calls, games, social media platforms, and so much more that was never thought possible. Innovation. We discovered new ways to put on concerts, perform plays, have safe sporting events, and even participate in online gym class. Crazy, right? Education. We managed to continue learning, sharing ideas, developing new thoughts in a world none of us knew could exist. Most of us may have been doing this from underneath our comforters, but that's besides the point. The point is that every single one of us here, graduates, teachers, board members, loved ones, everyone, went into this blind and came out stronger than ever. We found success in the eye of a hurricane, and for that, I am proud to be part of the class of 2021. Because ladies and gentlemen, look around. We made it. The end of high school. Now, we all have different plans for the next chapter of our lives. Many of us will be attending colleges across the nation and emerging ourselves into new and exciting fields of knowledge. A large group of us will be starting our careers early and utilizing our strength towards benefiting society. Now, there's also a number of us that will be joining the armed forces, putting forward their bravery to defend our great nation. Whatever it is that you may choose to do, just know that you will be ready. It is the strength you've had that proves this. To all the family members, teachers, staff, and board members, you should be proud as well. None of this would have been possible without you. Looking out at the graduates before me, I guarantee that we are ready for the next chapter of our lives. Once again, it is the strength that you've had to make it to where you are now that proves that you will be ready. So no matter how you're feeling about it now, just know that. Because I am ecstatic to see what you all will do. And although we have to say goodbye to these last 4 years, we do not have to say goodbye to each other. For we will always remain connected. We pushed through the greatest challenge that any of us could have ever imagined, and we did it together. So as you take that next step into your future, just remember that you won't be doing it alone. It is the combined strength that we all share that shaped us to be so powerful. Now and then, it has made us, and it will keep us forever Sequoia strong. Thank you.
Thank you, Eli. Now presented by our principal, Mr. Eric Hamilton, to Mr. Wayne Sabsack, president of the District 117 Board of Education, are slides featuring each of the graduating members of the Antioch Community High School Class of 2021.
Thank you. Thank you.
moment of change from student to graduate is traditionally marked by the turning of the tassels on the top of our caps. Please join us, class of 2021, in the turning of the tassels.
On behalf of the students, faculty, and staff of ACHS, thank you all for sharing this virtual commencement ceremony with us.
And special thanks to all the people who helped make this video commencement ceremony possible.
Once a sequoia, always a sequoia. Good luck, class of 2021.